Once upon a time in a faraway land, a young prince lived in a shining castle. Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind. But then, one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold. Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away. But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within. And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress. The prince tried to apologize, but it was too late, for she had seen that there was no love in his heart. As punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast and placed a powerful spell on the castle and all who lived there. Ashamed of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle with a magic mirror as his only window into the outside world. The rose she had offered was truly an enchanted rose, which would bloom for many years. If he could learn to love another and earn their love in return by the time the last petal fell, then the spell would be broken. If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time.
She's different from the rest of us. She's different from the rest of us. matter what. Now some may say all fathers just exaggerate.
That every daughter's great. And every daughter tends to say her mother's tough.
She pulls out all the stops.
If we keep quiet, maybe he'll go away. Someone there?
Not a word, Lumiere. Not one word.
I don't mean to intrude. It's just, well, I've lost my way in the woods and need a place to stay for the night.
Poor fellow. Oh, Cosworth, have a heart. Monsieur, you are welcome here.
I heard that. I know someone's here, and I'll thank you to step out into the light where I can see you.
Hello!
And goodbye.
Wait. Your clock. And your talking.
Astonishing, isn't it? And quite inexplicable. Goodbye.
Cogsworth, where are your manners?
We have to get him out of here before the master finds out.
This is incredible. How is this accomplished?
Really, sir, if you just... Ow! Oh. Really, sir, do you mind?
Well, I'm stumped. It must be some sort of newfangled scientific gadget.
I, sir, am not a gadget!
Oh, I do beg your pardon. It's just... Well, I've never seen a talking...
Bless you.
You are true to the bone, monsieur. Come, warm yourself by the fire.
No, I forbid it. Lumiere, as head of the South London Man, stop right now, the master's chair. I'm not seeing this.
Oh, la la, what have we here? Do my eyes deceive me, or is this a man? It's been so long since I've seen a real man. No offense, Lumiere. Bonjour, monsieur. Mind if I sit here?
Oh, well, hello.
All right, this time you've gone too far. I'm in charge of
it. Through! How would you like a nice pot of tea, sir? It'll warm you up in no time.
No tea. He'll be here all night. No tea.
There you are. Oh,
thank you. This is just what I needed.
Hi. Oh. I think I scared him, Mama.
Hello, little fella. Why, what's your name?
Jill.
Figures.
Care for a blanket, monsieur? I just love older men.
Ah, Babette, you are always trying to make me jealous. Well, it's not going to work this time.
Me? What about you? With Simon?
Jacques?
Michel?
Pierre?
Veronique?
Veronique! Oh la la!
Lumiere, listen to me. We have to get him out of here. Do you have any idea what the master will do if he finds out we let the stranger in?
Calm down, Cogsworth. It will be alright. The master will never have to know.
No!
On second thought, he's bound to find out sooner or later.
Should we
panic, Mama? No. There's no reason to panic.
Lumiere's right. There's absolutely no reason to panic. May I borrow this?
There's a stranger here!
Master, allow me to explain. The gentleman was sent upon my wound.
Who let him in?
Mama, Master, allow me to take something to explain. I was against it from the start.
Who dared disobey me?
Oh, dear!
You have all betrayed me! Who are you? What are you doing in my castle?
I lost my way in the woods and was needing a place to stay.
You're not welcome here.
All right. I'll just see myself out.
It's these, isn't it?
Oh, no, that's not what I meant.
You've come to serve the beast, haven't you?
No. I simply just lost my way in the woods and I needed a place to stay.
I'll give you a place to stay.
Like that. I can't bear it. I simply can't bear it.
change your viewings for me.
Oh, no. Never.
And we'll still have our little Rendez Booses, won't we?
Oh, yes.
Good. Well, if there's going to be a wedding, I guess I'd better go propose to the bride. I'm just full of surprises. For you, mademoiselle.
A miniature portrait of you.
Oh, yeah.
You shouldn't have.
Don't mention it. You know, Belle, there isn't a girl in town who would love to be in your shoes right about now. This is the day your dreams come true.
Gaston, what could you possibly know about my dreams?
Plenty.
Thank you. Hey, Belle, have you seen Gaston?
You just missed him. Wait a minute. Where did you get this scar?
Oh, this, in the woods. Pretty nice.
This belongs to my father!
Yeah, well, finders keepers.
LeFou, I want you to think hard and tell me exactly where you found that.
No.
Think!
Somewhere in the woods.
Harder!
Near the crossroads, okay? Ow!
Still out there somewhere. LeFou, you have to take me back!
Not the woods again!
Don't you see? Something must have happened! You have to take me back!
Not on your life.
Then I'll find it myself.
Couldn't keep quiet, could we? Just had to invite him to stay, didn't we? Serve him tea, sit in the master's chair.
I was trying to be hospitable!
Robert!
Ah, Cogsworth, you blame me for trying to keep what's left of our humanity! Look at us!
Look at you.
What about me?
You always were insufferable, but every day you become just a little more inflexible. A little more tightly wound. A little more ticked off.
Oh, please, spare me the stupid pot.
At least we are not as far gone as some of the others. You saw what happened to Michelle.
She always was too vain about her looks. And that's exactly what she's become.
A vanity.
Little drawers, a mirror, the works.
And poor Jean-Claude.
Who?
Jean-Claude. You know, not too bright, dumb as a...
A brick?
The whole wall.
Jean-Claude's brick wall?
That's him in the kitchen, behind the stove.
Tisk, tisk.
And Guillaume, the house boy.
That mealy-mouthed little bootlegger. I never liked him. He always was groveling at the master's feet.
He's a doormat.
Perfect.
It's happening faster than some of the others. As every day passes, we will gradually become things.
But why did we get dragged into this whole spell business? It's not like we threw that poor old Benwoman out on our ear.
No, but are we not responsible too for making him the way that he is?
I suppose so.
All I know is I will eventually melt away into nothing. I only hope there's a little bit of me left after the master breaks the spell.
We've got to hold on, old man. We've got to hold on.
Hello? Hello? Is anyone there? Please, I'm looking for my father. Papa!
It's a girl!
Yes, of course I can see it's a girl.
It's a girl, oh, mademoiselle!
I should do most of the talking. As head of this household, I should do most of the talking. Just a word, that's all I'm asking for. Just one word.
Get you out of here!
It's no use. You must get out.
There's done this to you?
There's no time to explain. You must go.
I won't leave you here. Who's done this to you? I know someone's there. Who are you?
The master of this castle.
Then you're the one responsible for this. Release my father at once!
I am the master of this castle. I do not take orders from anyone. Go out!
No, wait! Forgive me. Did you see he's not well?
Then he should not have trespassed him.
But he's an old man. He could die.
He came into my home uninvited and now has suffered the consequences.
Please, I'll do anything.
There's nothing you can do.
Please.
I said there's nothing you can do.
Take me instead.
What?
What did you say?
Take me instead.
You would do that. You would take his place.
If I did, would you let him go?
Yes. But you must promise to stay here forever.
Forever,
or he dies in the dungeon!
That's not fair! Wait. Come into the light!
Make your choice.
No, listen to me. I'm an old man. I've lived my life. You don't know what you're doing.
You have my word.
No.
What? No, wait! No, please! Spare my daughter!
No,
please wait! No!
Master! Master, please! Since the girl is going to be staying with us for some time, like forever, maybe you want to get her a more comfortable room.
You didn't even let me say goodbye.
What did you say?
See him again. And I didn't even get to say goodbye.
I'll show you to your room.
My room, but I thought...
Do you want to stay in that dungeon?
No.
Then you follow me. You follow me! This is your home now. You're free to go anywhere you like, except the West Wing. It's forbidden! You never set foot in the West Wing. Do you understand? Do you understand?
Yes.
This is your room. I hope you'll be comfortable here. If you need anything, my servants will attend to you. And one more thing. You will join me for dinner. That is not a request!
Should be light-hearted, never words so true. Mrs. Potts, I thought you might like some tea. Come in. Nothing like a nice, warm cup of tea to make the world seem a bit brighter.
But you're
Mrs. Potts, very pleased to make your acquaintance.
Oh, careful, darling.
Who are you?
Madame de la Grande Bouche. Perhaps you've heard of me.
I'm sorry.
Oh, you see, they have forgotten all about me. One can be, and I quote, the toast of Europe, the brightest star to ever grace the stage, but fall into one little spell.
Shh. Wait, this is impossible.
Of course it is, but here we are. Now, what shall we dress you in for dinner? This is nice, but how would you like to borrow one of my gowns? Oh, don't be silly. Let's see what I have. Ah, here we are. I wore this the night I performed at the Royal Opera. The king himself was there. I wouldn't have a prayer fitting into it now, so you take it.
Yes. Oh, that's very kind of you. But, I'm not going to dinner.
Don't be silly. Of course you are. You heard what the master said.
He may be your master, but he's not mine. Sorry. This is all just happening so quick.
It was a very brave thing you did, my dear.
I think so.
I'm gonna miss my papa so much.
Cheer up, child. Things may seem bleak now, but you mustn't despair. We're here to see you through.
Anyone can make the most of living here, then well, it's you.
Yes,
God
is the best and the rest is all trash. I've got biceps to spare.
Not a bit of him scraggly or scrawny.
That's right.
And every last inch of me's covered with hair.
No one hits like Gaston, matches fits like Gaston.
In the spinning match, nobody spits like Gaston.
I'm especially good at expectorating. To it!
10 points for Gaston.
When I was a lad, I ate 4 dozen eggs every morning to help me get large. And now that I'm grown, I eat 5 dozen eggs, so I'm roughly the size of a barge.
I won't even be mildly remorseful.
have brains like Gaston.
Entertain like Gaston.
And make up these endless refrains like Gaston. So his marriage we soon will be celebrating. My what a guy, Gaston.
No, thank you.
Fine, then stop!
acceptable.
What were we thinking? We will never be human again!
I suppose you're right.
Well, what would you two have us to do? Give up?
Yes.
I can't give up until I hear the sound of my boy's laughter as he roams these halls again.
Quite right, Mrs. Potts. We mustn't give up while there's still a chance. Lumiere, stand guard at the door, and if there's the slightest change, inform me at once.
Oui, mon capitaine!
Let's go.
I asked nicely, but she refuses. What does she want me to do, beg? Show me the girl.
I know the master can be temperamental, but underneath all that mad at fur, he's really not such a bad fellow. Why don't you give him a chance?
Why should I? To give my father a chance?
No. But once you get to know him.
I don't want to get to know him. I don't want to have anything to do with him.
Wrong decision in that which was gone, it left me in this state, an object of revulsion and derision. Hated, is there no one who can show me how to win the world's forgiveness? No, what did they say? Sour. Impress her with your wit. Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentleman.
Lumiere! Oh, Lumiere!
Oh, Babette, come to me, my little fluff. Ahoo! Jenny, you cut me to the weak. You think a little thing like that will make me lose feeling for you? And now you really tickle my fancy.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Oh, no, no, no. I've been burnt by you before.
Actually, madame, I am a little hungry.
Okay, I'll ring for Mrs. Potts and see you in honor.
That's okay. I'll go myself.
But what about the master? He's really not going to like this.
I know.
Oh dear, oh dear.
I like this girl. I like her spunk.
Well, if you ask me, she's being a bit stubborn. After all, he did say please.
I think that may be the first time I've ever heard him use that word.
I believe you're right.
You see? She's already having a good influence on him. Oh, there you are, dearie. Glad to see you up and about.
I am Cogsworth, head of the household.
Cogsworth, the girl! Excuse me, she's gone. I don't know where to go. I don't know where to look. She could be any... Enchanté, mademoiselle.
This is Lumiere. Oh, stop and stop that. Is there anything we can do to make your stay more comfortable? Anything, anything at all. You name it, I got it.
I am a little hungry.
Except that.
Cogsworth!
Well, you heard what the master said.
Oh, pish toss. I'm not about to let the poor child go hungry.
Fine. Glass of water, crust of bread.
Cogsworth, I'm surprised at you. She is not our prisoner, she is our guest. We must make her feel welcome here.
Fine, dinner. But keep it down. If the master finds out, he'll be at our necks.
Of course, but what is dinner without a little bit of music?
Music?
Marjorie, mademoiselle, it is with deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you tonight. And now, we invite you to relax. Let us pull up a chair as the dining room proudly presents your dinner.
guest, be our guest. Put our service to the test. Tie your napkin round your neck, chérie, and we provide the rest. Soup du jour, hot or dove, why we only live to serve. Try the gray stuff.
It's delicious.
Don't believe me, ask the dishes. They can sing, they can dance. After all, Miss, this is France. And the dinner here is never second best. Go on and fold your menu, take a glance, and then you'll be our guest. We are guests, we are guests.
Thank you.
about this castle being enchanted. It was you, wasn't it?
I figured it out for myself. I like to look around if that's all right.
Yeah, perhaps you'd like a tour.
Wait a minute. Perhaps that might not be the best idea. We cannot have you know who going you know where, if you know what I mean.
Not really.
Perhaps you'd like to give me a tour. I'm sure you know everything there is castle.
Well, actually, I do. May I draw your attention to the hand-painted ceilings, complete with sheriffs frolicking in delight amongst the nymphs and stintars.
Act like a gent. Act like a gent. This way we go. Oh, Bell! Bell?
Will you note the unusual inverted archways? This is yet another example of the late neoclassic Baroque period. And, you know what I always say, if it is not Baroque, don't fix it. May I draw your attention to the flying buttresses above the aviary?
Oh, Lumiere, it's all so beautiful. I had no idea. If only he weren't here.
Act like a gentleman. I am nothing but a fool.
And, thanks to some quick thinking on my part, that was the last time a stone of that weight was quarried in this area.
What's up there?
Nothing! Nothing of all of any interest in the West Wing.
So that's the West Wing.
Nice going.
I wonder what he's hiding up there.
Ha ha, hiding! What an idea, hiding!
Well, it wouldn't be forbidden, would it?
Perhaps, Mademoiselle, you'd like to see another part of the castle. We have exquisite tapestries dating all the way back to Aloysius the Pretentious.
Perhaps you'd like to see a tour of the gardens or the library.
You have a library?
With books!
Oh, yes, scarves of books, mountains of books, forests of books, cascades, cloudbursts, swamps of books.
Books with pictures and books. With words!
More words than you could ever read in a lifetime.
Oh, every book on every subject by every author who said pen to papi, yeah!
Don't touch that!
I'm sorry.
What are you doing here?
I
told you never to come here.
I know, but...
Do you realize what you could have done? Get out! I didn't mean to frighten you. I didn't mean to hurt you. You don't realize there's so little left of me. So little left. Driven to this side. infant lover. No passion could reach me, no lesson could teach me how I could have loved her.
Together.
I have just the thing. How about
we warm you two up a bit with a nice bowl of soup.
Soup?
Trust me. There's something sweet and almost kind, but he was mean and he was coarse and unrefined. And now he's dear and so unsure. I wonder why I didn't see it there before. Cheers!
Glances away, I thought I saw. When we touched, he didn't shut around my door. No, it can't be, not a signal. But then she's never looked at me that way before. She smiles at me, I get all choked up. My heart starts pounding and I can't breathe.
Oh, good, good, good.
That's good.
That is excellent.
I've never felt this way about anyone. I want to give her something, but what?
Well, there's the usual things. Flowers, chocolates, promises you don't intend to keep. No, you need to get her something special. Something that sparks her interest, something.
What, really? Well.
Say something about the dress.
It's good.
A compliment!
What a nice dress.
Thank you.
Well, I want to show you something, but first, you must close your eyes. It's a surprise.
Get the girl!
How can I open them?
All right. Now!
Tried a second time, and still he could not
So that must mean he's the king!
Wait and see.
I never knew books could do that.
Do what?
Take me away from this place. Make me forget for a little while.
Forget?
Who I... what I am.
We have something in common, you know.
What's that?
In the town where I'm from, the people think I'm odd.
You?
So you know how it feels like to be different. And how lonely it can be. For the third time, Arthur drew forth the sword, and there from the people arose a great shout. Arthur is king!
Told you so.
They're still in there?
Yes, and so far he has been a perfect gentleman.
You know what, Mama? I have a funny feeling inside. I don't know what it is, but it makes me feel kind of bubbly.
It's called hope, son. I've been feeling it too.
Ah, we, my little friend. I feel as though our time may be at hand.
If only that were true, Lumiere.
Human again. Yes! Think what that means!
I'll be cooking again, be good looking again, with a mademoiselle on each arm. When I'm human again, only human again, poised and polished and gleaming with charm. I'll be courting again, she gets sporting again.
Which should cause several husbands alarm. Shelf.
And to swing by myself!
I can't wait to be human again.
When we're human again, only human again. When we're knickknacks and whatnots no more.
Little push, little shove, you can push, oh no.
I surely won't totally be touch more. I'll wear lipstick and rouge and I won't be so huge. Why, I'll easily fit through. Soon set my fair, I'll be gold, I'll have heads, my prayer to be human again.
When I'm human again, only human again, when the world once more starts making sense, I'll unwind for a change.
Really? That'd be strange.
Then I hope it confines to tents. In a shack by the sea, I'll sit back, sipping tea, let my early retirement commence. Far from fools made of wax, I'll get down to brass town and relax.
When I'm human again, so sweep the dust from the floor. Let's let some light in the room. I can feel, I can tell, someone might break the spell in me dead now.
Shine up the brass on the door.
If it all goes as planned, our time may be at hand any day now. Open the shutters and let in some air.
Put these here and put those over there.
Sweep up the years of sadness and tears.
Close.
thank you for coming on such short notice.
Monsieur Dar, I don't normally leave the asylum in the middle of the night, but this fellow here said you'd make it worth my while.
Look, I've got my heart set on marrying Belle, but the girl needs a little, persuasion.
Turned him down flat.
It's like this. See? There's a danger I'll be thwarted and denied my honeymoon. For the pretty thing I've courted refuses to swoon. So the time has come for a murky plan, for which I turn to a murky man
to find that fiend.
Where better than the Maison de Lune? I don't take this girl for granted. There's no path I have in tune. To her heart, no seed unplanted, no flowers unstrewn. But quite amazing to relate, she doesn't want me for her mate.
Which forces him to contemplate
the Maison de Lune. I don't wish to seem a tad obtuse, but I don't see how I could be of use. For I love people up, I'm not some lonely hearts club. I'm a cold, cold fish, I'm a nasty, vicious drink!
Please speak.
It's Belle's father who's your client. She adores the old buffoon. She'll be forced to be compliant.
She'll dance to your tune.
We get the daughter through her dad. You just pronounce the old boy mad. Entirely clear.
It's the simplest deal of my old Valkyrie.
Put Maurice away and she'll be here in moments. In a dreadful state, she'll capitulate to me. Oh, I'll be strapping a bandit mate
very tightly,
very soon.
But please don't bring him in late. I'll check in. Time's noon, so wave one bachelor goodbye.
She'll be my bride.
Let her die, then have her daddy ask if I
in my sordid saloon.
So book the church, raise glasses high to the Maison de
Get our chairs.
Ow. Tonight is the night to confess your love.
Not so that I can do that.
You must.
You care for that girl, don't you?
More than anything.
Then why not tell her?
I can't.
You must.
There will be beautiful music, romantic candlelight, provided by myself, and when the moment is right...
How do I know when the moment is right?
You'll feel slightly nauseous.
No, you will feel it from here, and you must speak from the heart.
I must speak from... I can't.
You must. What are you afraid of?
Nothing.
Master.
I'm afraid she might.
She might what?
Love.
Somehow, my prince, you must find the courage to take that chance.
Master, look at the rose. There's so little time left.
I'm really not sure that I can do this.
Here, take this. It will bolster your courage. You can do it, Master. I know you can.
Thank you.
as it can be. Barely even friends, then somebody bends unexpectedly.
No
happened. The last thing I remember, I was falling.
Oh, you were in the woods, Papa. I thought I'd never find you.
But the beast, how did you escape?
Oh, I didn't escape. He let me go.
He let you go? That horrible beast?
Oh, he's not horrible. In the beginning, I was so frightened. I thought it was the end of everything, but somehow, things changed. It's funny. When I look around, I see the whole world differently.
Good afternoon.
Monsieur Diac.
I've come to collect your father.
What?
Oh, don't worry, we'll take good care of him.
My father's not crazy!
He was raving like a lunatic! We all heard him, didn't we?
Yeah!
All right, come along now.
No, you can't do this!
Now tell us again, old man, just how big was that beast?
Well, he was about 8, no, more like 10 feet tall.
You don't get much crazier than that.
Well, it's true, I tell you.
Tell me, Maurice, how long have you been having these delusions?
It's not a delusion. The beast is real, and so is the talking clock.
Oh, poor Belle. It's a shame about your father.
Gaston, you know my father's not crazy.
I might be able to clear up this little misunderstanding. If
what?
If you'll marry me.
What?
One little word, Belle, that's all it takes.
Never!
Have it your way. Take the old man.
No! I can prove my father's not crazy. Show me the beast!
It's him! That's him!
Is he dangerous? No, he never hurt anyone! I know he looks frightful, but he's gentle and kind! He's my friend!
Fine! You better run, so you had feelings for this monster!
He's not the monster, Gaston! You are!
She's as crazy as the old man! She said this creature was her friend! Well, I cut this wild beast, and I see what they can do! The beast will make off with your children! He'll come after them in the night!
I'll never do that!
Forget the old man! I say we kill the beast! We're not safe until he's dead.
He's mocking us at night.
Set to sacrifice our children to his monstrous appetite.
He'll wreak havoc on our village if we let him wander free.
So it's time to take some action, boys. It's time to follow. It's a nightmare, but it's one exciting ride. Say a prayer that you're there at the drawbridge of the castle, and there's something truly terrible inside. It's a beast, it's our fangs, razor sharp ones, massive paws, killer claws for the beast. Hear him roar, see him foam, but we're not coming home till he's dead. Good and dead.
We'll kill the beast!
Don't let you do this!
Try and suffer! Of this beast, who's with me?
I am!
Light your torch, mount your horse.
Screw your courage to the stinking place.
We're counting on Gaston to lead the way.
You want this, we want more. We're within a haunted castle, something lurking that you don't see every day.
It's a beast, what is cold as a mountain. We won't rest till he's good and asleep. Sally forth, Sally home. Grab your sword, grab your
take whatever booty you can find, but remember the beast is mine!
Hearts ablaze, banners high, we go marching into battle, not afraid, although the dangers just increase. Raise a flag, sing a song, here we come, a 50 strong and 50 freshmen can't be wrong.
But kill the beast! Kill the beast! Kill the beast!
creeps! Well, it does!
Shut up!
Gaston! I wanna go home!
Thank you. one look into my eyes, bound to recognize the beast within the man who's here before you.
It is you.
Wonderful.
Oh, Cotsworth.